In this lesson, we are going to talk about processing input from a GET request.
All right. What does that mean?
Well, request refers to the fact that when we access a web page, mm-hmm. we are basically sending a request to the web server.
Okay.
Generally, in the past, this has been things like accessing our array.php or anything else. That's sending a request to the web server saying that we want array.php.
Okay.
The GET method is a way in which you can send data to the server via the URL.
Mm-hmm.
So part of the actual request.
Okay, I gotcha.
Let's see. So let's talk about exactly how we would access that data.
Okay.
Inside of PHP, there are many predefined variables. Some of these variables can give you access to information about PHP, mm-hmm. information about the environment in which PHP is running.
Okay.
And some of those are dedicated to retrieving any data submitted via various request methods, including GET.
Okay.
So let's take a look at one of these predefined variables just to see how they work.
All right.
Let's look at a variable which holds the name of the current script file that we're in. This variable is known as $_server.
Okay.
This variable is an array, and we want to look at one specific key. We want to look at the PHP self key within this array.
So why is everything capitalized, though?
These are reserved variables. They're trying to keep the naming something that you wouldn't generally use.
Uh-huh.
And they're, because very often in PHP code, you'll find everything is lowercase.
Mm-hmm.
And this makes these variables, for one, they stand out better, easier to recognize.
Mm-hmm.
And also, this keeps them even farther away from something you might accidentally use.
Oh, so they're case sensitive, too.
Yes, variables in PHP, once again, are in fact case sensitive.
Okay.
So, we want to see what's held in this value, so we're going to echo it. So we'll echo the PHP self key of the $server predefined variable. We're going to save this file out as git.php because that's what we'll be using it for in just a minute.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go to our web browser and see what that script says. So we do in fact have data inside of that.
Yeah, that
script is, or that value is holding the fact that we are git.php. So, that's how we use a predefined variable.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's take a look at one that will specifically fit our needs for processing GET information. For this, we have a variable called $_GET.
Okay.
And we can pass it whatever data we need. Now, $GET is going to hold any data that has been passed. But up until now, we haven't actually shown how to pass data. How would we send data to the script? If we wanted to, back at the URL, data passed via GET is set up like such. After the end of the script name,
mm-hmm.
we add a question mark. Then we add whatever, I guess you could say, title for the data.
Okay.
So let's say we want to send text to the script. So let's say that the text is going to equal cat. We want to send the data cat to the script, and we want it to be recognized as text.
Okay.
And we send that. It does work. It's valid. But, of course, we're not showing it.
Right.
If we go back to our script now, we know what to place here. We know that we want to access some data that was sent via GET. More specifically, we want to access the data that is passed under text.
I see.
You can almost think of these as sub-variables that
mm-hmm.
we're passing to it. With the question mark, you have variable name equals some data. Those variables instead of are actually, they're actually keys or values stored within the GET array. So let's echo that out and see what happens. Check it out.
Oh,
it's working. Okay.
Cat.
So we can send cat to it. So can we send other things? Like weasels? Yes, we can.
Yay!
So at this point, we can send whatever text we want to the script and have it process it.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we could do a lot more than just echo. With this, we can now do whatever we want with the input values. We could store them in a database. We could run some type of calculation.
Mm-hmm.
For example, we could input a number and then run some type of mathematical calculation on it.
I gotcha.
So some other considerations. Let's see. What would happen if we omitted the value? In the past, we've seen that there has been problems we could run into if we try to use a variable that doesn't exist. If we try to echo a variable and it has not been defined, we'll get a notice.
Okay.
So what would happen in this case? So is this always defined? Actually, it's not. If we were to erase all of this back to just GET,
mm-hmm.
we'd get the notice of the undefined index for
right.
that array.
Right.
Now, we want to be able to make our script so that it can more gracefully handle this. We want a script that wouldn't all-out break
mm-hmm.
in the event that there was no data given to it. For this, we're going to introduce the isset function in PHP. Isset will allow you to check a variable and return true or false whether or not it was set. If it was set, it will return true. If it was not set, then it will return false. So I'll put this inside of an if statement. We'll say if isSet, give it this value, which I'm going to copy.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, if the get, or if the text key of the get array is set, return true. And if so, let's block this in and set it up such that this only echoes if we have the setup. Let me arrange my blocks. There we go. So if the value is set, then echo it. Otherwise, do nothing. And that takes care of our notice.
I see.
So
now it's just a blank page.
That's right. So if we put text equals cat, we get that. Otherwise, we get a blank page, and we have no error. Let's take this one step further and make it even a little bit more friendly. Let's add an else into the script, and so that we can actually handle the case of there being no data in that variable.
I see.
So in this case, we could echo invalid ID, or invalid text. And if we were to erase it, invalid text.
All right. So in other words, instead of showing just a blank page or an error, it's actually telling you invalid text.
That's right. So we can handle this any case we want, however we want with this.
I see.
Now, let's talk about multiple values. Yeah. This works just fine for sending a single value at a time. What happens if we wanted to have multiple variables sent to PHP via the get method? Back over in the URL here, you see so far we've had text sent. Now, let's say we also want to set a variable called ID. Maybe we want to load a page of some type of ID. To specify additional variables, we use the ampersand sign and then continue to specify variables. So we could say ID equals 45. And that's still valid. And at this point, if we wanted to continue adding variables, we could use the ampersand over and over again. Initially, we use the question mark. Then we have our first variable equals data. Ever after that, we have the ampersand, some value, ampersand, and continues. In this case, we only need one, so we'll set ID to 45. But, of course, we're not doing anything with it. So back over here, let's copy this and set it to also echo the ID. And one more echo. Let's make this more readable by putting a line return in.
Ah, I see. And there you go.
So we have cat and 45. Now, it would be a bad idea to erase 45, though, because we're not doing a specific check on that.
Ah, I see.
If we wanted to be absolutely safe, we'd have to put a duplicate of this or check both. With that, really, that covers all we need for the basics of getting data into PHP.
Okay.
Once again, it's really very simple. All you need to understand is how you assemble a GET request from the browser. And back in PHP, we can access any variable sent in the $_get predefined array.
I gotcha.
So with that, that's going to wrap up this lesson.
All right.